The DREAM Act, as mandated by President Obama, was meant to give children and teens brought to the U.S. illegally a chance to further their education, enlist in the military, or work.
But now a lawsuit filed in Dallas is saying the Obama administration overstepped its boundaries, and the suit could go all the way to the Supreme Court.
Devin Sanchez spoke to an attorney to get a breakdown of that lawsuit. She joins us now live with more.
That's right. The DREAM Act grants children who were brought to the United States before they were 16 illegally. It grants them temporary citizenship and a work permit, but there are some provisions to qualify. For instance, you must be younger than 30 years of age. You can't have ever been in any type of legal trouble, and you had to have been living in the United States for at least 5 years. But there's a new 38-page lawsuit out there that could put a stop to all the DREAMers.
A large quantity of the kids who are eligible for DREAM Act deferred action are in Texas, mm-hmm. and a lot of them are in West Texas. So if the district court in Dallas held that whole program to be illegal on the president's part, then that program will be shut down.
The Development Relief and Education for Alien Minors, better known as the DREAM Act, failed to pass through Congress last year. But President Obama drafted and signed an executive order, which was basically the same thing as the DREAM Act.
What the president has done by executive order is he said, we're not going to arrest any of you kids, and we're going to give you temporary status for 2 years, mm-hmm. and we're going to give you an employment authorization. Well, that's great.
Secretary of Homeland Security Janet Napolitano implemented the order, and now 10 ICE agents, 7 of which work in Texas, filed a lawsuit against the administration.
They're obviously quite upset that the president isn't letting them enforce the law the way they see it ought to be enforced. So, who have joined together and brought this case and said that the president doesn't have the right to tell them how to do their job.
The lawsuit issued by Judge O'Connor in a Dallas federal court could put at risk all the kids who have already filed for the DREAM Act benefits.
Very disturbing that it has started at all, because a federal district court has a lot of power. Because they're in the federal system. And so what they say has a lot of weight when it comes to, it brings the question to a point.
Attorney Mike Borland with Borland and Borland out of Midland says the requirements to qualify for the DREAM Act prevent any menaces to society from getting on the path to citizenship.
Graduate from school, they're in school, or they want to go to school. And, you know, they can serve in the military, hopefully. So if they want to do that. But yeah. It's for specific kids. They're basically good citizens, they're just not citizens.
Right. Borland says the suit will probably go all the way to the Supreme Court, but he hopes Congress will act before then.
Hopefully in the interim, Congress will act on comprehensive immigration reform, or at least give us the DREAM Act for these kids who brought here through no fault of their own and don't know any country other than the U.S.
Right. Now, in the decision, Judge O'Connor writes, the Department of Homeland Security does not have discretion to refuse to initiate removal proceedings. Now, the court has delayed a final ruling on this suit until May 6th, so we'll keep you updated on that. But for now, live in Midland, Devin Sanchez, News West 9.